apparently, before I got here, there were some lesbians in the studio. Now, first of all, let me say this. Because there were lesbians at the show last night, so that's two lesbian days in a row. First of all, let me say this. Lesbians, there's always a home for you here. You will not be judged here. You may be looked at. But I want you to know I am a fan of your things that you do. Now, I know there's people out there that don't agree with lesbians, and to you people I say, knock it off. Unless, of course, you're in some way connected to CBS, then I say, oh, great. Anyway, what happened is I came out and there are some, the lesbians that were here last night had a row all to themselves. And then I came out and there are girls sitting in lesbian row who are not lesbians. And I'm thinking, this is like a dream come true. Anyway, that's enough of that salacious talk about lesbians and stuff. Let me just tell you this. Tonight's show will be the usual classy enterprise involving grown-up humor. And, hey, we won a Peabody. So, do you know what that means? Means the Peabody committee took their eye off the ball once. Everybody makes mistakes. Sorry, Peabody Committee. So it'll be the usual sexual innuendo and fart joke. See you in a minute.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by T-Mobile, the Family Network.
Spectacular, very believable in every way, and I really enjoyed it, especially the young lady over there who was going and then when I saw you and you were going like that and you went and I was like, aha! But it was a lovely smile, a lovely, I love a warm hand on my opening. What the hell? I was like, wow, I'm complaining about your phony enthusiasm. Look at me. Hey, everybody. Are you ready for some used car bargains? Do you know what? It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, it is. It is. It is. It's Friday, of course. Friday. Oh, thank goodness it's Friday, the day when I celebrate things. And you know what I'm very excited about? Not so much Friday this week. Friday's okay. Saturday's all right because I get to lie in bed and do some things. And then... But what I'm looking forward to this week is Sunday, because this Sunday is Grandparents' Day. I'm very excited about that because it's the day we take time to celebrate the old folks, or as CBS calls it, sweeps. Now... Hey, what? I know I'm a couple of days early, but let me be the first to say, let's hear it for grandparents, everybody. That's right, grandparents. I said, let's hear it for Grandparents' Day. Everyone, please call your grandparents this weekend so they can't complain that their grandkids never call. That can be a problem. But there's usually blame on both sides. A lot of time people call their grandparents, but the grandparents answer the blender. Hello? Stop yelling, robot man! Robot man? Yeah! Robot man called robot granddad. Grandparents' Day actually became officially recognised in the 1970s. Now, it would be easy to dismiss Grandparents' Day as one of those fake-ass holidays. You know, the ones made up by the greeting card companies to sell more cards, like Second Cousins' Day or Landscape Professionals' Day or Valentine's Day. That's right, I said it. Valentine's Day's a scam. Cupid doesn't care about you. He's a little diaper-wearing bitch. There, I said it. Oh, Greg, you're not a romantic. Aren't I? Ain't I a romantic? I'm as romantic as the next guy. I'm quite romantic. I just don't like to be told I have to do it on a certain day. That doesn't seem romantic at all. That just seems planned. That seems manipulative. You're right, ladies. Let's end this Valentine's Day madness. I look forward to your letters. Please wait till February 14th. Now, it would be easy to dismiss Grandparents' Day, but it would be wrong. It would be wrong. That was pretty good acting right there. Look at that. Grandparents are America's most natural, precious natural resource. They are grandparents. Well, no, gold. Gold is probably. And then oil. And then forests. large areas of agricultural farmland. Grandparents are important, is what I'm saying. They're in the top 50 things that are important. What? I love the elderly, especially when they kickbox on YouTube. That's hilarious. Grandparents deserve our respect. I know it's sometimes difficult listening to some old guy prattling on about nothing, but you're watching this show, so you can take it clearly. What?
That's what I like about you.
What? Say that again.
That's what I like about you.
You're starting to sing. Can the Jeff Peterson Skeleton Robot Broadway musical be far away?
I hear that, girlfriend.
Yeah? That would be awesome.
You just applauded an appliance.
What's up? Oh, Grandparents' Day, that's what I'm talking about. Grandparents are a blessing. Remember, they won't be around forever, so you have a limited amount of time to steal their pills. Do you know, it's no secret I took some drugs back in the day. I'm not proud of it. I'm not saying it's a thing. CBS in no way condones my actions, but I gotta tell you, the best I ever got in my life was from my grandma. I'm not kidding. Like, seriously. There was once I had had some particularly long weekend where things had gotten out of hand involving stimulating powder. And I happened to be having a conversation with my grandmother, who I hadn't seen in a while. I said, I can't sleep. And she's like, why? And I said, I don't know. And she said, well, never mind, son. Here, try one of those. Take a half of one of those. And I was like, all right. So I took a half of one of these drugs, which cannot be named. I slept for the weekend. And when I woke up, I was taller. So if you're lucky enough to have your grandparents still around, call them right now. Pick up the phone. I don't care if it's the middle of the night. Good old, you know, a good old startle. The old folks love that. What? I miss my old grandpa and my grandmas. I miss them. What you should do is call them up. Hold the phone to the TV. Hold it. There are kids on your lawn.
Rock Hudson is gay.
Word!
And for grandparents who are watching, I hope to join your elite ranks one day. I'm going to take it seriously as well if I make it. I'm going to move to the big leagues of grandparenting. I'm going to go to Florida. I'm going to move to Florida. I'm doing the whole thing. I'm going to wear the boxy Terminator robot glasses. I'm going to sit low in my car like that. I pull my pants up to here, right up to my nipples. I'm going to have my belt right on my nipples right there. And a big giant tie all the way down to my wiener. And I'm going to walk around with that. Shorts with the really tight nylon socks pulled up my legs. I'm going to eat dinner at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Yes.
Jeff won.
Yes, and I'm going to have a big cold house that smells of vitamins and wee wee. I'm looking forward to it. Oh, it's commercials time. Good, I hope they got some of those things I like.
That's right, Grandpa.
I like the sound of that.
In your pants.
In your pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
Nope.
We'll be right back. Thanks, everybody. If you're just joining us from the commercial break, usually during the commercial break, I entertain the audience with my fantastic mouth organ. Then I play the harmonica.
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
In your pants.
In my pants?
So cold.
What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's a perfect time for some tweet mails.
Also, emails.
All right. Let's get started on the tweets and the emails, then. What do we have here? What? The doorbell? I'm trying to work here. What's going on? Donald Glover! Hey, dude.
What's up? How's it going?
Good, man.
Good.
Hey, Don Glover. Nice new glasses, by the way.
Thank you.
Yeah,
appreciate it.
Yeah, they're good. They're very...
Yeah, they're very big. I don't usually wear them on the show, but I felt like, you know, we're close now. So I've been on here like, what, 40,000 times?
Yeah, yeah, quite a lot.
Yeah, yeah. So I felt like I could wear the glasses.
Yeah, sure. Why not relax? Take your shoes off if you want.
Really?
No.
Okay. Because I don't wear socks.
Yeah, actually.
You might faint.
You don't wear socks?
I don't wear socks.
What are you,
I
some never kind of hippie?
I do eat organic food.
Do you really?
I try. I try and stay healthy.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, obviously it didn't work in your eyes.
Yeah. No, it did not. Don't eat it. I didn't say what I ate that was organic. Yeah. I didn't say fruits and vegetables, you know.
What do you eat then? That's
like,
organic.
Like organic, like, I don't know.
Fries?
Fries.
Yeah. Right.
Organic.
Don't say it, man.
All right, yeah. Fine.
Hey, Donald, this is not a guest spot. I was just doing the tweets and the emails. I was doing that.
Oh,
you
yeah.
could help me out with that.
I would love to do that.
All right.
I really would.
This is what happens every time you come here, isn't it?
Yeah, lately.
That's weird. Well, you know, it happens.
I don't have anywhere to, so I...
I noticed that on the Twitter. You're all over the place. I follow you on the Tweety, and you're like, oh, yeah, I'm in New York. I'm in
San Jose this weekend, yeah.
San Jose?
Yeah.
Shut up!
Yeah.
I'm going to be in San Francisco this weekend.
Are you serious?
Absolutely. Let's go and meet some lesbians.
Yes.
Yes.
I would love that.
Yes. I'm going to be in San Francisco. It's just down the road.
Yeah, I'll come visit you.
Yeah,
hang
I'll come
out with
visit
some lesbians.
You. Yeah. Well,
do
I don't know that lesbians would care to meet us.
I'll find some.
All right, then. All right, then. Well, you can help me with the emails, then. This is from Amanda in Orlando in Florida. She says, Dear Craig, and she'd probably say Donald as well, if you know.
If she knew.
If she knew. She said, how should I deal with high school bullies?
Huh.
Ah, see, how did you deal with them? Because clearly you were a target.
Oh. I honestly, sincerely was. How did I deal with them?
Yeah.
Just took it. Just got beat up. I know that's horrible advice, but sorry.
Actually, I think it's pretty good advice, because the advice I got when I was bullied as a kid was, you know, hit a bully back and then they'll go
away.
No, they don't. All right, this is from Jesse in Macon, Georgia.
Macon. I know where that is. I'm from Stone Mountain, Georgia.
That's Georgia. Yeah. Says, Dear Craig, and Donald, look, you're in there too.
Oh my God.
Yeah. All right.
Wow.
How do they know?
No idea.
She's prescient.
Did you just do something from Lord of the Rings there?
A little bit.
Yeah, you did. She's prescient.
She's prescient.
Yeah. Yeah. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're not kidding about that bullying, though, are you?
No.
All right. She says, will you follow me on the Twitter, please? Well, she doesn't. You don't put your Twitter thing on it. You know, you can put your name on
it. It's just a picture of a bird.
Yeah, it's a picture of a bird. That could be anyone on Twitter.
Now I'm angry. I'm just gonna block you now.
Yeah.
I'm like,
do you ever block people?
I've never really done it.
I've done it.
Oh, is it cool?
It's awesome. It's like being Stalin.
Just being Stalin.
Yeah, you just kind of go, you don't exist anymore.
Does that keep them from messaging you and also from them showing up?
They just go out of your life. Yeah, it's amazing.
I wish they had that in real life.
Yeah, I know.
Mom.
Bullies.
I love you, Mom. I'm just kidding.
Oh, we talked about your mom before, right?
We did.
Yeah. How's she doing?
Yeah, I think you know.
She's a lovely woman.
She is a very lovely woman.
Hey, baby. Kid looks great. You're doing a great job, really. The glasses, I'm not sure about, but anyway. All right, this is from Paul in St. Cloud.
Okay.
You ever been to St. Cloud?
No. Where is that? Minnesota.
Yeah. Okay. You been to Minnesota?
No.
What's wrong with you?
I don't know. I'm too busy being in San Jose, places like that.
San Jose, yeah.
Hanging out with the lesbians.
They got lesbians in Minnesota.
Do they? Do they?
Probably a couple.
Well, they have to be a couple, otherwise they're not lesbians.
No? Yeah. You could be a lesbian of the mind. Oh, yeah. I have to be a couple. Man. Getting all conservative.
I'm sorry. It's just you need another lesbian to be lesbians, right?
Well, technically, I suppose, yeah. But, you know, there's sometimes I've seen entertainment videos when a woman is on her own and drives herself crazy. Just on her own. Mind you, that means if I have sex and I'm on my own, that means I'm having sex with a guy, which means I'm gay.
You're gay. Then every dude is gay. I think we solved it.
I think we solved a lot of problems right there.
I think we solved it.
So no one gets married. All right, let's see. This is from Lewis in Houston in Texas. Ever been down in Houston? Nice down there.
I've been to Austin. This is close.
Not that close. Texas is big, man. It's the size of France.
It is huge.
I mean, it really is. It's the size of France, Texas. It's huge. Less cheese. But more hats. Of a certain type.
Of a certain type. Yeah.
All right, Lewis in Houston, Texas says, Dear Craig, my roommates hog the bathroom every morning. How should I approach them about this? Now, you're a young fella with the roommate situation. Do you have a roommate?
I actually do not right now, but I did for a long time.
Right. Did they hog the bathroom?
Dudes tend to not really hog the bathroom, but I was an RA at NYU, and the girls would always have that problem.
What's an RA?
An RA is like a resident assistant. It's when you live on in the dorm and help out the new kids, like the freshmen.
Awesome.
I know, it's good. I was the only boy on one year. I was the only boy. It was awesome. Oh, man. It was great. So I think we answered the question, pretty much.
I forgot the question.
Yeah.
This is from Thomas in Vail in Colorado. Now, you must have been there.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You like the skiing?
I do.
Yeah, I like skiing. Yeah. I love skiing. I'm not very good at it.
I'm terrible at it. My feet go like that, so I can't stop because you're supposed to.
Yeah, you got to do like, it. Yeah, pizza, French fries.
Pizza. Yeah. And he was like, I was trying to do it, and he kept being like, pizza. I was like, I can't. I'm only French fries.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I was like, it was really.
I'm like, macaroni. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, Thomas in Vail, Colorado says, hey, Craig, and Donald, he'd probably put that in.
He would have.
Is it okay that my girlfriend is taller than me? She likes to wear really tall heels. It's awesome.
Yeah. She's gorgeous. I don't. She can be as tall as the building.
I like tall women. I think tall women are sexy.
They
I like tall good. Women, short ones, fat, thin, lesbian, straight.
They are pretty great.
They're great.
There's nothing. I love women's of all types. Tall, red.
Women's of all types.
Women's of all types. Animals, dolls.
What you say?
I'm not on TV, am I? Can I start over?
Yeah. Do you like women?
I love them.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah, no, you're all right. You're good.
Right,
you're amongst
good.
Friends.
Yeah, great.
Yeah. So San Jose then?
San Jose.
Yeah, and I'll be in San Francisco.
I really will try and see you.
Well, I'll really try and see you. Are you doing a stand-up show?
I am doing
stand-up. I'm doing a stand-up show, too. What time are you on?
I'm on at 8.
Me too. But we could maybe meet up for dinner afterwards.
That would be great.
I'm meeting the Mythbusters.
Are they, oh, yeah, they're in San.
Yeah, they're coming to my show.
That's awesome.
I know. Myth that I'm funny, busted. Will you come?
We're good. Yeah.
Well, we'll line up.
Absolutely.
All right, Donald Glover, everybody, Donald. It's only with the big countdown to Grandparents' Day on Sunday where we're gonna go. My first guest tonight is a very beautiful actress, a friend of mine. She's on the Sons of Anarchy show Tuesdays on the FX channel, which is, great. Please welcome the lovely Katie Sagal, everybody. Katie Sagal. You, Katie, good Lord, well, look at you.
Oh, my.
Wow.
I wore this for you.
Well, yeah, that, I'm glad you wore it. There's nothing that sets me off like a purple leopard.
I thought you'd like it. I did.
It's
I actually got
nice.
It special just to come and talk to you.
Really?
Yeah, I couldn't find the right thing to wear, so I went out.
Well, I think you'd be fine in anything, but this is just this lovely. How
Thank
are you?
So,
you well?
I'm really, really well, yes.
Really?
I loved hearing your monologue. When did it be okay to say...
What's that coming to go?
I had to say it. I'm on a series right now. I'm on a network where, you can't use that word, and I've just been
you
wanting to say
it. You can't use it here,
right? Yeah, but you did.
Yeah, I use it, but CBS, although they care, they don't really care about me. So
I shouldn't say it again? I can't say it again.
I so enjoyed the way you said
it. Did you?
Yeah. Yeah, because you said it in a special way.
I did?
Yeah.
Just for you.
You knew the way you said it, too. It's almost as if you'd said it that way before.
Maybe. I might have, yes.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi, baby.
Hi.
How are things going on the Sons of Anarchy show, then? Everything all right?
Yeah, we're shooting it up. We're banging it up. We're doing...
And then you're going to work.
Yeah, and then I'm going... Yeah. No, I do that at work.
Is it season three?
It's season three, and we just premiered last Tuesday night.
On the FX channel?
BAFO ratings, yes.
BAFO?
Yes, people are really... Thank you if you watch Sons of Anarchy.
It's the motorcycle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You'd like it. I think you'd like it. Have you watched it?
I have a motorcycle.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Do you wear your helmet and you're safe? Do you have a Harley?
No, I have an Indian.
An Indian? Oh, I like an Indian,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, yes, that's right. That's right.
Yeah,
no, I have an Indian, very nice motorcycle. But I can't ride it much in L.A. It scares me riding around in L.A. in a motorcycle.
I know. Yeah. My husband is now riding a motorcycle. And
really?
Well, he writes the show, so he always used to ride motorcycles. Now he's done it again. And I, you know, it's the one thing we disagree on.
Right? You don't ride a motorcycle?
I don't. Well, I have three children, and I, you know, I'm really nervous about that. I don't even like to get on an airplane, so.
Airplanes can be a little safer.
Safer.
Yeah.
It's scary for me.
Really? Are you frightened to fly?
I was just on a flight. I was just coming back from Hawaii, and that scary thing happened where we took off, and 10 minutes in, the guy goes, "Something's wrong. We're turning around." Mm-hmm. And I just burst into tears, even though they all tell me it's all fine. I'm a scared flyer.
I was a terrified flyer, and then I learned to fly.
Oh, you can fly a plane?
Yeah, I got a pilot's license and a motorcycle. Uh-huh.
You, wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Man.
That's right.
And you're married now,
that's
too.
Right. That's right. Now you got a little thing.
See, I am too, but I didn't wear mine.
You didn't? So.
Congratulations,
thank
by the way.
You very much indeed. Yeah.
So,
mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you don't write. You're frightened to fly. Well, you were in Hawaii.
I was in Hawaii. Yes, I was having a little vacation. I had a week off, and I took my older two kids.
Yeah.
To Hawaii, we had a ball. We had
what did
the
you
best
do?
Time.
Did you go and they eat the spam and go scuba diving?
No. We ate the pineapples and we went ATVing. Have
ATVing?
You ever done that?
Well, no, I usually ride my motorcycle around, but the ATV.
You're so tough.
I am a little bit tough.
You are
see all
tough.
That kind of ooh-hoo stuff that I do. That's not really me. I'm more kind of.
Are you?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, a little bit,
I like that.
You went ATVing?
We did. Well, I didn't actually ride the ATV. I drove in the little car behind my son and his friend.
Yeah, that doesn't really count as ATVing then.
It was hardcore, I'm telling you, because it was up a mountain road and under a waterfall and
a waterfall.
Bumpy. Yes, it was beautiful. It
now,
was
why would you be frightened of flying and then go ATVing? Isn't it? What was wrong with the plane, by the way, when you had to turn
it
around?
It was this is what they told me.
Right.
Who knows if it's true? Right. It was a malfunctioning light. Like the light just went on, and all of a sudden you're landing, and there's fire trucks and. And then
the fire trucks were out?
Oh, yes. When you have to go back, they bring the thing and, you know. And then they said it was a bad light bulb.
Uh-huh.
It's like, yeah. Right.
Yeah.
You know, sort of like the plumber. He comes to your house. He says, you need this, this, and this.
I like where this is going.
Well. Yeah. Or the dentist.
Yeah, or the pizza delivery guy.
Tell you need all these things and you don't really know. If you
I always think the dentists are kind of like the carnies of the medical profession. You know what I mean? They're kind of like, roll up. Oh, you need an implant in your mouth. All
right.
That kind of thing.
Did you know dentists have the highest suicide rate?
Oh, I'm sorry I said that, dentist.
Which I didn't realize that, but it's
really?
Sort of, you know, but I think it's probably because, you know, nobody really likes your dentist. Nobody likes to go.
Actually, I quite like my dentist.
You do?
Yeah, he's a pilot. Weird, right?
Yeah, but do you like when he's digging around in your mouth?
No, I don't like that,
yes,
but...
that's what I mean.
But I don't... It's not personal. He's not doing it because he's a bad guy. He's doing it because he has to pay for aviation fuel.
I see, right. Yeah. Well, I like my dentist, too, but I think that sort of overwhelming feeling that nobody really wants to go see you...
Yeah.
...makes him
that's
sad.
What it's like to be Scottish. Kind of. You imagine a Scottish dentist are like...
Oh, horrible. I like the Scottish.
You do?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, have you been over there much?
I have not, but we have a
that'll be why you like them so much then, yeah.
Well, we have one on our TV show, a man named Tommy Flanagan. Do you know Tommy?
I know Tommy Flanagan, I think.
Yes.
There was Tommy Flanagan in Braveheart.
He was in Braveheart.
Yes.
He's a fantastic actor.
He's a very good actor, Tommy Flanagan.
I can barely understand a word he says, but
yeah,
he's
fantastic. Yeah, me too. Yeah, me too. Yeah.
You Scottish with that accent.
Well, I've apparently lost my accent completely.
Says who?
People in Scotland, they're like, oh, listen to you, you Yankee Doodle.
Really? Oh, no, I think you still sound
I think I sound
Scottish.
Reasonably Scottish.
I do, too. Yeah. In an American sort of way.
Well, I am an American. I've been here 15 years now.
So are you a citizen?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
I got my tattoo and everything. Look at that.
Well, let me see that. Yeah, what does that say?
It says join or die.
Oh, you are such a badass. You should come be on the Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah.
You're a badass.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, no, I have three tattoos.
Do you?
Yeah.
Where? This one?
Here and other places.
Ah. I too.
You are so bad.
I'm really not that bad.
Nah, come on.
I'm not.
So where do you, have you become a bike mama now? Do they invite you to all the bike rallies and stuff?
I do. I have a whole new audience, it seems. I was actually on the cover of, what was it called? It was a big biker magazine. And there
probably
I was.
Probably Biker Magazine.
Something, biker, yeah. And but yes, and I do. I go to biker rallies and
have you been to Sturgis?
Oh, yes, we went to Sturgis on the first season of our show. It was great. Lots of Harleys and it was wonderful.
What do they do? They just drive up and down? Jay Leno was there and stuff?
Well, I didn't see Jay there, no, but they do. But they all drive.
Yeah, that's how badass you are. Jay Leno can do it.
That's right. And there's all different kinds of bikers, you know, you meet all different kinds, just in any walk of life.
Do you ever see any, maybe seem an odd question, but you think there's such a thing as a lesbian biker?
I've met several. Yes, really? Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I imagine they probably are.
Yeah. Why are we, you were talking about lesbians earlier, yes.
Probably.
How did you get... Were there lesbians in the audience? Is that
right? I wish. No. I'm cool with it. It's all love, baby.
Oh, you're totally cool with it. You're a guy.
Hey, I'm cool with guy love, too.
You are?
Yeah, sure.
Ah.
Yeah. No. It's not really my box of macaroni, you know, it is what it is.
What was that whole French fry pizza conversation? I just caught the end. Were you talking about skiing and?
Yeah, skiing. You know, French pizza, French fries.
Because you do the. I never.
Do you ski?
I have skied. I'm not a very good skier. I don't like.
Clearly, you don't know pizza, French fries. That's the essential part of skiing.
I thought it was the bunny. I can't remember now.
The bunny?
The bunny slope or the bunny. Oh, that's the slope you go on when you're learning.
Yeah, that's the name of the little.
Do you like skiing?
Yes.
Man, you are a daredevil.
Oh,
aren't
man,
you?
I swam with sharks this year.
You did not.
I sure did.
Wow.
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
What do you mean? What does that mean you swam with sharks?
I went in the water. There were
and they
big
were right next to you?
They were right there, and I fed them a little bit of fish on a pole, and then it was on Shark Week in the Discovery Channel. I'm telling you, it was awesome.
It was? You're an adrenaline junkie. It's that.
Well, I'm a junkie. Adrenaline is quite. I mean,
adrenaline
okay, if it's
got
to be adrenaline,
that's
then right. It'll have to be adrenaline.
And that's all that's left.
Yeah, that's
it.
Adrenaline
work.
And hats. We're done now. That's it.
Are we? Are
yeah.
We're done. All
what
right.
What an awkward pause.
Oh, do you know? We should just mention one thing. Did they all watch Futurama when we were on together? You know,
oh,
I was.
Yeah,
remember,
yeah,
you were
yeah.
Susan
I played a
Boyle.
On your ass.
You were the Boyle, right? Did you see it?
Yeah. Do you have the clip of that?
It's so.
We should show the clip.
It was so good.
Thing.
You have a Boyle on your butt that sings show tunes with you?
Don't look at me. I'm a freak.
No. Well.
I've been ashamed of Susan as long as I can remember.
You named your Boyle Susan?
A Boyle can't have a name. They also said a Boyle can't sing. But Amazing Grace! Oh!
Ew, she's Scottish.
Katie Sagal, everybody. We'll be right back.
Hey. What the hell are you doing?
I gotta borrow a ride.
What are you talking about?
Is that your truck?
Hey, you're not doing this.
Let go of me!
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Okay. I gotta go home. He needs me.
My next guest, this is the cover of my next guest's latest album. Look at that adorable creature. And that dog's nice too, right? She's a beautiful and talented songster. She's here to perform a song called Man of the Hour. But it's really about dogs. Look, there's dogs on the back. Hey, no. Please welcome the adorable Norah Jones, everybody. Norah Jones.
It's him or me, that's what he said. But I can't choose between a vegan and a pothead. So I chose you, because you're sweet. And you give me lots of loving, and you eat meat. And that's how you became my only man of the hour. You never lie. And you don't have any baggage tied to your 4 feet. Do I deserve to be the one who will feed you breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and take you to the park at dawn? Will you really be my only man of the hour? Flowers, they will only die. And though we'll never take a shower together, well, I know you'll never make me cry. Well, you never argue, you don't even talk, and I like the
freaked me out a little bit. Oh, and by the way, bullies. When we talked about bullies, I really think you shouldn't do that. You shouldn't bully people just to make yourself feel better. You know who I'm talking to. Yes, because people always need you to, you know. I don't like bullies. Does anyone like bullies? Bullies don't even like bullies. It's not like they have a club. Oh, bullying's our thing. I mean, it's like... They don't have a parade or anything. We're the bullies. Things are fabulous, you know? Knock it off, bullies. Stop trying to get people to do stuff. It's America. Bullying is un-American. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Now, let me just say, before we go as well, that it is Grandparents' Day this weekend. And I want to say to all the grandparents out there, probably best check the medicine cabinets once the kids are gone. Because some of the stuff you guys got in there is spectacular, really.